In this episode, we're discussing what do mechatronics engineers do, and we're starting right now. Hey, 1% Nation, I'm Jake Voorhees, and welcome back to the 1% Engineer Show, where we empower young engineers to rise to the top 1% of their career. So if this is you, make sure you hit the notification bell and subscribe. Check out the description below for links to the 1% Engineer Kit, access to our Discord server, go ahead and sign up for a free account on thanks.com, one of our sponsors, and access to our Instagram page. If you want to be a mechatronics engineer, what type of industry do you want to work in? Robotics, signals and controls, rocketry, nanotechnology? Technology, let us know in the comments below so we can make more videos about that. I also want to give a big shout out and thank you to Hamza Wahid, who's the director of operations here at 1% Engineer, and he wrote this script. So let's jump right into the video, guys. Mechatronic engineers design and maintain machinery with electronic and computer control systems, such as aircraft, robots, motor vehicles, cameras, power generators, and mining and chemical plant equipment. Mechatronics engineering is hugely broad with lots of opportunities to work in different sectors and different roles and different capacities all across the board. We'll go over the 7 subfields within mechatronics engineering. But truly, all of these subfields are within the realm of systems optimization, particularly for the optimization of automation of industrial or mechanical systems. Mechatronics is the combination of the words mechanical and electronics. A mechatronics engineer is someone who applies the principles of mechanics, electronics, and computing to generate a simpler, safer, or more economical and reliable system. Okay, now that you have an intro, let's talk about the history of mechatronics engineering. The word mechatronics was first used in Japan in the 1960s, and the field has considerably grown outside of robotics alone. Early on, robot arms were uncoordinated and had no sensory feedback. But as advances were made in programming, sensory technology, and controls, the robotic movements became more coordinated. Along the way, advances in mechatronics began to be used in vending machines, autofocus cameras, and even door openers. With the advent of information technology in the 1980s, microprocessors were introduced into mechanical systems, improving performance significantly. By the 1990s, advances in computational intelligence were applied to mechatronics in ways that revolutionized the field. The concept of applying the mechatronics approach to design, development, and fabrication has been popular for several decades in Japan and Europe, but is only slowly gaining ground in the United States. That's why so many of you ask about this field, is because it's still relatively new. I get more requests for this video than any others right now. Machines were traditionally designed by mechanical engineers, and only afterward were control and programming solutions provided by computer and software engineers. As familiarity with mechatronics has grown in this country, designers have come to see this more sequential approach as inefficient and are adopting more integrated design methods. All right, with that simple history, let's go over the tasks and duties. What do mechatronics engineers actually do in their career? When you begin any engineering career, you start off learning the fundamentals of whatever industry you are in, and you may be doing any of these tasks or duties. A mechatronics engineer may design, develop, maintain, and manage high technology engineering systems for the automation of individual tasks. You may apply mechatronic or automated solutions to the transfer of material components or finished goods, or design and assist with the manufacturing of consumer products such as cameras and video recorders. You may carry out studies into the feasibility, cost implications, and performance benefits of new mechatronic equipment. You may apply electronic and mechanical processes and computers to tasks where the use of human labor may be dangerous, for example, underwater exploration, mining, or forestry. All right, very simple task and duties assembly there. Let's go over those 7 subfields within mechatronics engineering. Robotics. I get so many questions about robotics. Robotics is an interdisciplinary research area at the interface of computer science and engineering. Robotics involves design, construction, operation, and the use of robots. The goal of robotics is to design intelligent machines that can help and assist humans in their day-to-day lives and keep everyone safe. An example of a robot is an industrial robot found in a car manufacturing plant, which is welding parts together. Digital control systems. Digital control is a branch of control theory that uses digital computers to act as system controllers. Depending on the requirements, a digital control system can take the form of a microcontroller to an ASIC to a standard desktop computer, which incorporates several of the individual control modules. This third subfield is automation. Automation is the technology by which a process or procedure is performed with minimal human assistance. Automation, or automatic control, is the use of various control systems for operating equipment such as machinery, processes in factories, boilers and heat treating ovens, switching on telephone networks, steering and stabilizing of ships, aircraft and other applications, along with vehicles that include minimal or reduced human intervention. An example of automation is the self-driving car. Machine or computer vision. Machine vision is the technology and methods used to provide imaging-based inspection and analysis for such applications as automatic inspection, process control, and robot guidance, usually within industry. Machine vision refers to many technologies, software and hardware products, integrated systems, actions, methods, and expertise. Instrumentation. Instrumentation is a collective term for measuring instruments that are used for indicating, measuring, and recording physical quantities. Instrumentation can refer to devices as simple as direct reading thermometers, or as complex as multi-sensor components of industrial control systems. Today, instruments can be found in laboratories, refineries, factories, and vehicles, as well as in everyday household use. Smoke detectors, thermostats, devices like this. Biomechatronics. Biomechatronics is an applied interdisciplinary science that aims to integrate biology, mechanics, and electronics. It also encompasses the field of robotics and neuroscience. Biomechatronic devices encompass a wide range of applications from the development of prosthetic limbs to engineering solutions concerning respiration, vision, and the cardiovascular system. Biomechatronics also includes removable gadgets such as exoskeletons. Finally, you have avionics. Avionics are the electronic systems used on aircraft, artificial satellites, and spacecraft. Avionics systems include communications, navigations, and display and management of multiple systems, and the hundreds of systems that are fitted to aircraft to perform individual functions. These can be as simple as a searchlight for a police helicopter, or as complicated as a tactical system for an airborne early warning platform. A really cool creator on YouTube called Everyday Astronaut has some videos about this, and you can see his work, you can see his content to get a better understanding of avionics. All right, with those subfields covered, let's talk about the work environment of a mechatronics engineer. Mechatronics engineers work in industries such as robotics, aerospace, medical and assistive technology, mining or defense, material handling, human-machine interaction, manufacturing, unmanned aerial and ground vehicles, and within education. They may work within a laboratory conducting research. They could work for a high-tech company, a large global enterprise, at a processing plant, within a corporate engineering office, and can also be involved with research in emerging fields like bioengineering, nanotechnology, and robotics. Mechatronics engineers may be required to travel to present at a conference or view a new design or innovative technology, even collaborate with another team, participate in training, things like this. Okay, now let's talk about the PE, the professional engineering exam, if mechatronic engineers should achieve that. There's a big divide between how much programming you have to do within your engineering career and how much design you have to do within your career that suggests where you should be on the spectrum of to not take the PE or take the PE. And so if you do design work, if you're gonna be on the mechanical side of mechatronics, then you most likely should sit for the FE, the Fundamentals of Engineering exam, after graduation from university, so that you can be a PE one day and you can sit for the professional engineering exam after 4 years of experience designing components. If you are far to the other side of the spectrum, on the electronic side, you may be on the heavier programming, signals controls, the coding applications of mechatronic systems, and therefore you don't necessarily design and you may never actually need that PE behind your name. So depending on what you want for your career, depending on where your expertise may be, make the right decisions for you. Even if you are on the programming side and you're more of an electrical engineer working within a mechatronics engineer ecosystem or heavily skewed towards the programming side of mechatronics engineering, and you still want to have a managerial career and have the best salary you can get and be in leadership one day or be some sort of technical division head, then you should get your PE no matter what, because it helps you stand out. It really does boost your salary a little bit, shows your ambition, and there's almost no bad things that can come from getting your PE. So I always say, go ahead and do it, guys. All right, I get so many requests about this video. I hope it helped you. If it did, comment below on what type of industry you want to work on, what type of dream job you want to achieve within mechatronics engineering. So many people tell me, I just want to do the things that Tony Stark can do. What type of engineering is for me? I think it's mechatronics is what they ask. And it's basically true. So I had a lot of fun doing this video. What should we make next? Thanks again for watching the 1% Engineer Show, guys. We're coming back with a whole bunch of great videos. So make sure you subscribe and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss anything. And if you want to be a 1% engineer and rise to the top 1% of your career, then make sure you join the Discord server. Make sure you sign up for the 1% Engineer Kit so we can help you the most. Thanks again, guys, and we'll see you in another video. Bye-bye.